welcome you all to Sahasrara the Ascension, and I am here today with a pick a card reading to let you know what the new moon in Gemini and the solar eclipse has in store for all of us. Please remember that the effects of this solar eclipse will remain till December 2021, so up to 6 months for now, and I will try to convey the messages I am getting. Please take what resonates and leave the rest. So here we have three piles. Pile number one with the green aventurine, pile number two with the rose quartz crystal, and pile number three with the amethyst crystal. So just close your eyes and set the intention what the new moon in Gemini and the solar eclipse messages are for me, and then open your eyes and whichever card you are called to, that is the right pile for you. You can choose based on the cards or based on the crystals as well. Please remember, nothing is right or wrong. You can choose one pile or two piles or all the piles. Okay, so let's start with the reading. So we'll begin with pile one. Hello pile one. So if you have chose this green aventurine, this is your reading for the new moon in Gemini or the solar eclipse. So let's just first cleanse the energies. So let's see what the new moon in Gemini and the solar eclipse has in store for my pile ones. Okay, so I have used 5 decks over here, and if you like the cards and if you want to know what cards I am using, so all this is linked in the description below. Okay, so let's just start with the angel answers card first. So pile one, what I am getting is there is a balance of feminine and masculine energies coming up for you, and I am also getting you are going towards a divine union. I am also getting twin flame vibes, or you are balancing the feminine and masculine energies within yourselves. Okay, and whatever you are trying to do, don't be in that very much perfectionist mode. Ask help from others. Don't hesitate to ask help from others, because the help is available to you. And I'm also getting like angels are also there to help you. So you just need to connect to them. You just need to ask help from them. They are always there to help you. I also see a spiritual growth for you. And look for the signs. Angels are giving you the signs. So just connect with them. Connect with those signs. And start working as per that. And I'm also getting that there are a lot of new opportunities coming. Maybe you are growing, like this growth will like this will be like very much big growth for you. You may travel, you may need to travel across faraway places, maybe away from your home, but remember, these opportunities will bring you lot of abundance. Maybe some adjustments or compromises required, but I would recommend to grab these opportunities because they are for your highest good and they will bring you a lot of abundance. And if you are facing any issue, I'm getting any issues with a Cancer sign, or maybe you are facing any emotional issues currently, so you will start seeing clarity on that. Okay, and full moon in Cancer may be significant for you. I'm getting lot of water sign vibes, so I'm getting your intuition is getting stronger and you need to communicate clearly. That's what I'm getting. Also connect to Archangel Michael. Archangel Michael is there to help you, to assist you to resolve any issues or blocks expressing yourself. Okay, so I am getting a lot of clarity coming in and lot of positive movement for you guys. And I'm getting your heart chakra getting cleared. I'm getting number 2. Number 2 might be significant for you. Also number 9. From number 9 I'm getting, this is like these 6 months you will be like closing a very big cycle which might have been like lasting from long time, and you will be entering a new cycle. I see lot of healing coming in for you in the upcoming 6 months. I am seeing lot of ancestral healing also coming in. So, and trust your intuition. Just flow with what your intuition is trying to tell you. Okay, and don't forget to take time out for yourself. Okay, so give yourself that time to rest, rejuvenate and recharge. Okay, and I see a lot of movement, lot of positive movement that is coming very strongly. Now what you need to surrender? Now surrender obsessive thinking. So I'm getting times may come where you might feel that things are not working out, the past is repeating itself, and you may get into that negative thought process. But it is time to have that unconditional trust in the divine. It is time to have that faith that everything is working out for the highest good, and don't worry, the past is not going to repeat itself. In fact, you are clearing and healing all that might be pending from your side, or you might already be thinking that I have already healed, why this is coming out. But you are healing it once and for all, so that you are going afresh towards the new beginning. Okay, so I hope you like the messages and I hope this helps. Thank you. Hello Pile 2, so if you have chosen this rose quartz, these are your messages. So let's just first cleanse the energies. So Pile 2, I'm getting lot of self-love vibes. Or maybe you are getting into that more loving energy. You will be embracing yourself as well as others. And I'm getting you, like, you will be more into that loving energy towards yourself, towards others, and towards everything in your life. I see more acceptance coming in, and you're enjoying, you're loving the flow of life. That's what I'm getting. Now let's see what the cards are telling us. Wow, the first card itself says abundance. And the number 8 also signifies abundance. So I feel lot of abundance coming for you guys. And I see whatever you are doing, keep on doing that. Start working and start doing from the space of love. That's what I'm getting. Maybe some spiritual venture for some, if you are waiting to start that spiritual venture. So don't take a step back and go ahead, and because it is going to bring you lot of abundance. I'm seeing lot of abundance vibes, guys, and I'm seeing your connection with the universe getting stronger and stronger. I'm seeing your higher chakras being more advanced, especially your crown chakra. You are getting connected more and more to the divine, and you will start getting lots of messages from the divine. You will start getting a lot of downloads. So be in that receiving mode and don't get overwhelmed. Ground your energies, and these downloads are coming to you for a reason. So it is your responsibility to process them in a proper way. So be ready for that. I'm getting many of you guys here might be star seeds as well. So you will start receiving messages from your tribe. I'm getting maybe many of you start connecting with your soul tribe over the period of these 6 months, or at least you will start seeing some signs that you are getting closer to connecting your soul tribe. Okay. And I'm getting a lot of Jupiter vibes, and I'm seeing a lot of clarity coming to you, lot of light coming into your life. Whatever was not clear or maybe foggy, that's getting cleared. And I would suggest connect more to the moon and stars, and embrace the beauty of the universe, especially of the skies in the nights. So maybe stargazing or taking a walk within open space or under the sky and connecting to the stars, observing the sky will really soothe you, will really ground you. That's what I'm getting. And communication is the key. So whatever you are receiving, don't forget to communicate it to the maybe your tribe or maybe the people around, because you are receiving those messages so that others can get that knowledge, others can get that divine guidance. So it is your responsibility. So don't be in two minds whether I should go ahead or not, whether it is true or not, what people will think about me. Okay. So remove all this negativity or blocks from your mind. Just go ahead, take that first step, because it is part of your soul purpose. Oh wow, now the next card itself is surrender to your soul's path. So you are meant to do this, you are meant to walk on this path. This is your soul's path, this is your calling. So don't hesitate and do that. I'm getting the grounding messages I got, so connect more with nature. If possible, go to the places near water. It will calm you, it will soothe you, it will reduce your overwhelming energies, it will balance your emotions. And yes, your intuition, it is getting heightened. Lot of mystery vibes I'm getting. So even if things are unknown, even if these are not familiar territories, don't hesitate. That's what I'm getting. Don't hesitate and just go ahead with that unconditional trust, because this is your soul's path, and walking on this path will bring you a lot of abundance. That's what I'm getting. So all the best, and I hope the messages help. Thank you. Hello Pile 3. So if you have chosen this amethyst crystal, these are your messages. Let's just cleanse the energies first. So this is like my all my spiritual people, all my light workers, healers, my star seeds, my energy workers, all my empaths. Okay, so I'm getting lot of spiritual growth coming to you. Spiritual ascension is happening. Over the next 6 months, you will be a different person altogether. That's what I'm getting. And I'm getting you will be shining your light more brightly, because I see your spiritual gifts heightening. Maybe your clairs or your channeling abilities. You might be putting lot of meditations. You might be reading cards. But I see a huge shift and growth in your energies for the highest good. If you are already walking your soul's path, I'm getting you are going to the next level, and you are not yet aware what your soul's calling is. You are definitely taking the first step towards it, or maybe you are awakening towards your soul's path. Okay, now let's see what the cards are saying. If you believe in the flow, a new start is coming. So pile 3 is, I am seeing you will be connecting more to the ascended masters now. I am seeing new spirit guides coming in. Maybe right now you are feeling maybe stuck or not feeling that much connected to the divine or your guides or angels, but I see it getting resolved during these 6 months. And I'm getting you have to believe. You have to believe in yourself, in your angels, your guides, in the universe, in ascended masters, because they are all there with you. They are working for your highest good in the 5D. You just have to have that faith, and you just have to hold to your light within, so that you are connected. Maybe if you are feeling you are not connected, but still you hold that light within and you are connected to your guide. So don't forget that, because that belief is going to take you forward. And it is not applicable only just for 6 months, but throughout your path. That's what I'm getting. And you're spreading your wings, guys. You're spreading your light. And I see a lot of success coming in for you. If you are running any spiritual business, I see you spreading your wings and flying high. And I see a lot of angelic support for you guys. So angels are there supporting you. And your guides and angels are working in the background for you. So just have that faith, have that trust. Maybe you need to work on healing yourselves right now, because once this healing is done, you will open lot of new doors for abundance. For maybe you will come to know lot of hidden gifts that you already have, that you might have already within you in this lifetime, or maybe from many lifetimes before. So you might tap into those gifts. Just focus within, believe in yourself, believe in your angels. I'm getting a lot of sacred geometry vibes. So connect to Archangel Metatron. Archangel Metatron is there to help you, to guide you. Okay. And I'm also getting a lot of Buddha vibes. So meditate more, you will receive your answers during meditation. Maybe like epiphany and awakening and lot of clarity coming to you during meditation. Okay. And just have that faith, just go with the flow, just have that trust that everything is working in the divine timing for the highest good. Because just going with the flow will definitely help you. Maybe you are not seeing that warmth, that light as of now, but soon you will be getting signs, or soon you will be seeing the results. Okay. Maybe you are putting lot of hard work as of now, but not seeing any results, and you are feeling disappointed, or maybe you are not reaping the rewards for your efforts. So don't get disheartened, guys, because a new start is coming. This new moon on, I'm not sure, 10th or 11th July. So this might be significant for you. Okay. You are maybe currently you're feeling lost or not seeing any clarity or feeling stuck and not able to move further. So from this phase, you will start moving in this phase where there is lot of universal connection, lot of light, lot of spiritual growth, and lot of light for you. Okay. And as I said, you will start seeing that speed in your life, in your career, in your spiritual growth, in your ascension. And I'm seeing connection with the ascended masters getting stronger and stronger. Maybe I'm also getting for some new ascended masters will be coming in to guide you. So just be in that open and receiving mode, because your life is going to speed up. Just have that faith and have that trust. Just some more time. I think after this new moon, things will start speeding up. Or at least you will start seeing the signs, you will start getting the clarity, and you will start spreading your light more and more. So what you have to do right now, surrender to the non-action. So maybe you are feeling like, why I should keep on doing that, why I should keep on pushing myself, because nothing is happening. So just surrender to that non-action. Okay. Now is the time to be still and not act. So now is the time to heal yourself and maybe slow down, breathe a little bit, focus on yourself, and don't get distracted from the energies outside, or maybe you need to protect yourself from the energies outside, slow down a little bit. When you feel like I don't want to do anything, take that break and don't feel guilty about that. Okay, so just give yourself that time to relax, to breathe, to be with yourself. Okay, that's what I'm getting. So just being in that mode will help you recharge, and to once you recharge your batteries, once you fill your cup, you'll be able to give others more, with more love and with more light. So that's what I'm getting. But don't stop, keep moving ahead. Surrender to non-action does not mean like not taking any action at all. So whenever you feel like, take those breaks, give yourself that me time, relax, rest, but keep moving ahead, because you will start seeing your manifestations and you will start seeing your life moving in the positive directions very soon. Okay, so I hope this message helps. Thank you. So I hope you like the video, and if you like the messages and you like the video, please like, share and subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to press the bell notification icon so that you will get notified for all such upcoming videos from my channel. Until we meet next time, bye.